And this time we turn the palms forward and then up and lift the chest way, way up. And down. Good. You look beautiful, all of you. And lift way up and down. Good. And then just let the elbows cross for a moment and lift up. Good. And open. Great. Now we softly bend the right elbow and again feel that lift coming up through the chest. And then just allow that arm to continue on out towards the back. And now turn your head around and look if you can still see it flowing away. And down. And then we take the left one and lift. And let yourself reach way back. And all the way. Good. And down. And now we take both arms and just let them cross. Feel the rounding, the widening of the back, and just push everything out of the way. Way out. Good, and down. And then we come, bring the elbows together in front and lift up. Way up. Way up. And open wide. Good. And now we just let the arms hang and we bend over and they can come up in the back behind you and let them gently bounce over your head forward. And then just drop your right arm. Just let it drop and hang and let it just make little circles there, just like a seaweed. And then your other arm that's on top is another kind of a seaweed that gets pulled out of the water and your body just follows up. So you come up in a spiral, softly, all the way and down. Good. And then just let yourself hang over once more. And now you let your left arm come. No, sorry, right arm come up in back of you. And just let your left arm make circles and circles the other way, just floating in the water. And then that somebody's pulling that arm that's up there, that big seaweed out of the water, and your whole body just follows along, way up and over. Good. Now we let both arms move towards the back. Both arms move towards the back. You really came out of the water, didn't you? You needed air. Yes. And then we take both arms to the back and we bend in the hip joint and let them be way, way up towards the ceiling. And now feel how your back can just slide from side to side. So you're moving your whole middle back and the arms just follow along. But it's the back that's moving. Let your back be moving from side to side. Great. And once more each side. And then just drop your arms and let them hang. And slowly turn around towards your right heel and turn around towards your left heel and then just swirl around in the water. Let your head hang. And then slowly, slowly come back up, hands in the hip joint and unfold out of that joint. Good. And let your arms cross and take another breath. And open wide and let them come down. Good. And just let your hips go again from side to side, softly. And then just reach out and reach out and reach. And then one more and let the arms come down and let them cross in front. And open wide. good. And then we hold hands and have the legs a little bit apart. And then we very gently start to pull, not too hard, so that person can really once more feel how far the arm can reach without pulling the person over. And then over to the other side. And pull gently, gently. Don't have to bend forward. It's a bending from the side and over. And let your head go. And feel that pull that you are being given by the person next to you, so your shoulder blade can just glide out. And come back to the middle. And just take another breath. And come back down. Good, great. How are we feeling? So just let yourself lie down. And just feel the floor underneath you. It's a moment of checking in with yourself. And then bend your knees. And just feel how much more of your back is touching right now. And then just very gently, with your knees together and your feet are together, just begin to rock a little bit from side to side across your pelvis. Not too fast. Just feel yourself really rocking across this whole pelvic area, but very gently. Good. Great. And then have your arms out shoulder level. And this time when you go to the right side, let your knees go all the way and let your head move in the opposite direction. Do it slowly so you feel the whole spine getting the twist. Knees are together and over to the other side. Keep your knees together right now. That's it. Gently. And over. And come up. And then stay up in the middle and take your right knee and your left knee up into your chest. And gently bounce them towards you. Keep them together, bounce them towards you. That goes a little deeper into your lower back area. Not too hard, Walter, not too hard. Gentle, gentle bounce. And then let the right leg and the left leg lift up to the ceiling. And gently bounce. This is for stretching the lower back. Good. Great. And now while your legs are up there, let them go from side to side and feel how your abdominals have to start working for you. This is abdominal work now. Gently, from side to side. Good. And then start making three circles around one side, around one direction, three circles, and feel how much more deep you have to go into your abdominals to support this movement. Keep the legs up, Walter, keep the legs up. And then three circles in the other direction. Not too fast. Those are all movements for the lower back. You don't want to whip your lower back. You want to be gentle with it. And then bend your knees and put your feet on the floor. And let both knees once more go to the right and see how it is different from the first time. Arms are out shoulder level. Let them slide over. That's it. Feel your chest opening wide. And over to the other side. Feel that wonderful wideness of your chest. And come back to the middle again. And now take your right knee and your left knee up towards your chest and put your hands on top of your knees. On top. Fingers are facing down. Now just gently walk your legs forward and back a little bit. Just walk your knees forward and back. That's it. Not apart. Forward and back. One and the other. And then hold onto your knees again and slow the whole movement down. Fingers are facing downward. So now let your right knee walk out and let it go slowly so you feel this. Hang on to your knee. So it stretches up into neck and shoulder. Don't do anything extra with your neck there. Just let your head lie down. That's it. Then change over to the other side and feel that pull right up into the neck and shoulder area. Not so fast. That's it. Little slower. Feel that wonderful stretch. Good. And one more. Good. And then let your knees come together again and then start making circles. Guide your knees around in a circle, each one in their own direction. Out. Soft. No, don't work so hard. That's it. Just feel how deeply you get into the joint. And then reverse your circle. Let them come together. Let them go down and out to the side and up. That's it. All feel how much space you have opened up in your joint. That's it. Good. They're coming apart. That's it. Yes. You're making circles. That's it. Good. All right. And then put your feet back down on the floor. Have your arms out shoulder level. Feet are on the floor. Feet are on the floor. Arms are out shoulder level. And now let your hips lift up all the way. Slowly. Don't toss them up. It's not a ball. That's it. Feel the stretch. Feel the stretch through the hip joint. Now think you're starting to come down from the top of your spine like you wish to lay down each vertebrae at a time. Slowly down. The tail is the last thing that comes down. Good. Very good. And once more, let your hips go up. And let them come up. Good. Great. And one more. Let them come down. Let them come down. Good. And rest. And let your legs stretch out. And roll over to your right side. And have one leg on top of the other. Legs are out straight. Support yourself in front with the arm. Support your head with the arm on the floor. And now lift both legs up and down. Beautiful. And isn't that beautiful? And lift up. Yes, great, Wally. And down. Now I'd like you to lift them just a little bit, just a couple of inches, and just swing them forward and back a little, straight legs. So you're swinging again in the hip joint. Just a gentle swing. Great. Yes. Very good, huh? And put your legs back down. And now just bend your top knee and get a hold of your ankle. Good. And gently pull it back a little bit. Pull it back. Don't yank it back. Just let that muscle stretch. Good. And relax it. And pull it back. Good. And now, as you come, bring the knee back in again and put your hand underneath your knee. Bend your knee and put your hand under. Underneath from the outside. Now stretch your leg all the way up to the ceiling, slowly. And bounce it towards you a little bit. That's it. Good. Great. And then just let it float down to the other leg. Good. and roll across your stomach to the other side. Support yourself well first, so you have good support on the floor. And lift both legs up, and lift them, and down. And once more, lift them up, and down. Feel that middle corset working. And one more lift, great, good, and down. And now bend your top knee and get a hold of your ankle. Don't yank it. Slowly, slowly pull back. Slowly pull that leg back and feel that quadricep muscle getting a stretch. And relax it. Good. And once more, give it a pull back. Good. Nice. And relax it. And now scoot your hand underneath the knee from the outside. Keep it bent first. And then stretch your leg all the way up to the ceiling. Good long stretch and bounce it towards you. Good, great. Got a charley horse there? And then let it just float down and rest. And roll over on your stomach and bend your knees. Come up on your hands and knees. And just while you're up on your hands and knees, just let your back round up towards the ceiling and let your head hang all the way down. Just feel this connection from the top of your spine to the tip of the tailbone. And then softly let yourself move in the opposite direction. The spine sinks down, the hips come up, and the head come up. Just let yourself feel that mobility of your spine, and once more, round way up. Good. And then let it go and soften. Good. And then find the middle position of your back, where you're all in one even line with your back. Head right from the top of the head to the tip of the toes. And then bring your right knee up towards your nose. See if you can touch. And then stretch your leg out and back. So stretch it up. Good. That's it. And once more, round your back and bring that knee way in. And bring it back and stretch it out. Good. So once more, there's a good long stretch through the body. And bend the knee and put it down next to the other one. And then take the other knee, bring it up to the tip of your nose. Great. And then stretch it away and reach up. And one more time, in, good. And stretch it up, good. And now just bend the knee and stay on your hands and knees for a moment and just wiggle your seat a little from side to side. Not so vigorously, be a little nicer to your body. Just feel how everything moves very comfortably. It doesn't have to get pushed here and there, so good. And now let your seat move towards your heels. Let your seat move way back, good. And let your arms stretch out in front of you. Way out, way out. Give yourself a long stretch. Great. And then slowly round yourself back up again. And curl your toes under. Yeah, that's another one. Do it next time. And curl your toes under and push away from the floor. And turn around once more so you can face everybody in the circle. And just let yourself lift up once more for a nice big breath and open wide. Did anybody get tired doing this, what we did just now? Because that's not the purpose of it. You felt this down there, huh? Yeah, it got stretched a little, huh? But I mean, does your body feel now I can go about my day? Yeah. Light and easy? Great, that's the whole purpose of Rosen movement, to be ready and feel good to go out and do whatever the day will bring. Have a good one.